Hi, Rotamba. If you are watching this video, it means you are interested in satisfying your curiosity as far as the alternative method for showing that this particular function is whether it is continuous or uniformly continuous on the set of real numbers is concerned. Thank you for that. Let's go and see whether we'll be successful in doing that. Now, we are to show that this is continuous or uniformly continuous on the set of real numbers. So to start, this is the function you have been given. I want to show whether it is continuous or uniformly continuous on R, the set of real numbers. And so we'll say that X naught belongs to R. And if X naught belongs to R, then we can say that the limit of S squared as S approaches S naught is equal to this. That means the limit of the function as S approaches S naught is equal to the function value. Right. So this is what we have. Now, this approach, what we want to do is to be able to change everything into sequence. Okay. And we know dealing with sequences, then we are talking about natural numbers. But one thing we have referenced in our video, as far as a real number system is concerned, is that for real numbers, natural numbers are also part of the real numbers, which means that we can say that the set of natural numbers can be looked at as a subset of the set of natural numbers can be looked at as a subset of real numbers. It means that we can find natural numbers in the set of real numbers. Now, on that grounds, then we want to convert everything, change everything into sequence. So this one becomes x and a, that's the sequence, will now give us, so we're going to look at it as xn squared. So everything is now being changed into a sequence. Now let this particular sequence here converge. Okay, if it is converging, so we let this particular sequence here converge to, so it should converge to what we have in here, so x. So it should converge to that. Let's say that it should converge to ya. So to put something like that, y. So let this particular sequence here converge to that. Now, but we want to define this, so we also say that we also want to let x and y be equal to a certain function like this. So we are setting the parameters for this particular function. So we let this be the sequence and it's converging to this. And now we are letting this particular one be equal to this. This be equal to n, which means that this one, we are supposing that it's a sequence and it's converging towards n. So I haven't set those things in place, then we can say that from here, saying that the limit of f s squared as s approaches this is like that, now becomes the limit of the sequence which we have now is this. So this n plus 1 over n. But realize that this place is being squared, so the sequence is here, this squared, but this is this. So we have this place to go squared. As n approaches infinity, it will be equal to, and we said that this one should converge to a certain value n. So it means this will be equal to n. Alright, so this actually picks us back to our concept of finding or proving that the limit of a particular sequence exists or is equal to this. Means that we need to remember and state the equivalent statement of this. I hope you've not forgotten. If you have forgotten, you need to watch other the previous videos to actually be conversant with this test. I'll give you the benefits of it. Now let me give you the equivalent statement. When you have this one, it means that given epsilon greater than zero, then there is, okay, a certain big N, which is a function of epsilon, so that this particular big N is a function of epsilon, and it belongs to the set of natural numbers. And so that if we are having N to be greater than big N, then the absolute of the sequence, which is N plus 1 over N squared minus the limit N, should give us epsilon. Now you remember that epsilon is a very small number. It's very close. It's almost zero. It's a very small number. Now what it means is that if at the end of the day we'll be able to show that whatever we have is actually less than epsilon, then we can conclude that this particular function here, it is continuous uniformly on the set of real numbers. Right. So if we are able to show that all this is less than epsilon, that means the given function is uniformly continuous on the set of real numbers. Let's see whether we will be able to reach that level. So we repeat this one. We have n plus 1 over n squared minus n. You find the average of this. So let's try and expand this again. So the expansion of this, you realize that this is going to give us n squared, then plus, so we're going to have 1 plus 1, then plus, alright, so we're having n. Okay, so let's do this, let's see, n plus 1 over n, then plus 1 over n, then plus 1 over n. Okay, so this will give us n squared. And this will be given as plus 1, then this one to plus 1. So what about this and this? This and this will give us 1 over n squared. So we're having n squared plus 2, then plus 1 over n squared. So it means that this point will be given as n squared, then plus 2, then plus 1 over n squared. Okay, then we have that, and then alright, so minus what we have here is n. Good. Alright, so coming back to what we are looking at here, the limit of x squared as s approaches s means to refer to this, which we are trying to transform, saying that this one is converging to this. Alright, so it means that what we reach here, we should have n plus 1 over n all squared. That should be equal to n squared. So that this place becomes squared, and this place is also squared. So we have this place is squared. So we move on. Now we do that this and this is going to give us this answers this. Alright, and leaving behind 2 plus 1 over n squared. So we have that. Now, whatever we have here will result in a positive value. So we quickly write this as 2 plus 1 over n squared. Now, 2 plus 1 over n squared. Now, if we pick the limits of all this, so that as n grows larger, so as n goes larger, we realize that 1 over n squared also goes closer to 0. So as this approaches infinity, this one also goes to 0. So realize that whatever we are having now is what? Is 2. This particular 2, and what we are trying to show is that this will be less than epsilon. But we realize that whatever we are having now is 2. And 2 cannot be said to be less than. This is not less than epsilon, it's actually greater than what? It's greater than epsilon. So now, we have not been able to
state that this particular sign is less than epsilon, which would have led us to concluding that this particular function is uniformly continuous on the set of real numbers. Contrary to that, we are now getting 2 to be greater than epsilon, because epsilon is a very small number. And so on these grounds, we say that the function f of s equals x squared is continuous here, but not uniformly continuous on R. So we say that this, on the basis of this, we conclude that the function f of x equals x squared is continuous but not uniform. Continuous on a set of real numbers. I hope you've enjoyed this, you found this very helpful. This is just an alternative method to what we have done earlier. Alright, so thanks very much for your attention. We shall meet again to look at issues like the derivatives and the intermediate theories and the rest. Catch you. Let's do it.